Good morning, St. Pius. It's me, Namdeon Yunike.
And I'm Philip St. John.
Stay tuned, because you're watching The X Factor.
Yep.
Schedule, Monday, Tuesday, Friday schedule.
Don't forget it.
Saint of the day is Blessed Luke Belluti. Saint Anthony was preaching conversion to the inhabitants of Padua when a young nobleman, Luke Belluti, came up to him and humbly asked to receive the habit of the followers of Saint Francis. Anthony liked the talented Luke and personally recommended him to Francis, who then received him into the Franciscan order. Luke became Anthony's companion after Anthony's death. He was appointed guardian of the Friars Minor in the city of Padua.
Good guy.
Yeah.
Sophomores and juniors, do not park in the front. But I say do it anyways, because that'd be fun.
But don't do it.
Oh.
Seniors, Unicode scholarship applications are due by March 9th. Applications is on the scholarship station section of Mr. Murphy's website.
Angel's Attic loves working with St. Pius on offering service hour opportunities for its students. Their goal is to provide a comprehensive volunteer experience that requires the students to show up as scheduled, work diligently, and serve joyfully. The best way to sign up to volunteer is to email JC at jcblinsler, that's it, at gmail.com.
There's a family looking for a nanny over the summer for their two boys. They're looking for someone on Monday, Tuesday, and Thursday from 8 to 5:30 with some Friday mornings. Ideally, the person would be a responsible driver. If you're interested, see Mrs. Martin.
No irresponsible drivers allowed.
Yeah, you have to be a good driver. Attention all Blue Tribe members, fellow Blue Tribers, Blue Tribe baby. If you are interested in a service opportunity with our Hillcrest Hope apartment, please see Miss Barda after school today or sign up outside of her door.
Gold Tribe for life.
No.
Please check the lost and found for coats, lunchboxes, water bottles, fleeces, etc. Please. Also, please remember if you lose glasses, jewelry, or electronics, Mrs. Bors probably has them in the office. It's happened to me before. Just go. Just do it.
Tomorrow, Tuesday, February 25th, during lunch, my boy Jeff from Jostens will be here to deliver graduation announcement orders. If you have a balance due, please bring it in at this time with cash or money order only. If you need to place a cap and gown order, please see the sales rep at this time. Please remember, checks are no longer accepted as a method of payment for your graduation order.
Cash only.
Yeah, Jeff from Jostens will hook you. I actually don't know if it's Jeff from Jostens. It's someone from
Jostens. It better be. The ministry team will be having a charity bakery sale today and tomorrow, and all proceeds will go to the Sisters of St. Francis.
Sports for tonight, District Girls Basketball versus Crystal Ray at Cameron. So good luck, districts. It's going to be, let's see if we can get out.
Lunch for today. It's Papa John's. You already knew.
All right, our story slash segment for today is Black History Month. What's good, St. Pius? Namdi and Marcus here. And, you know, it's Black History Month, and it's already almost over, and we barely talk about Black History Month here at St. Pius. So we are here today to talk about, you know, give you a lesson on black culture, hopefully every day this week.
Yes, sir.
All right, person I'm talking about is the guy I like to call the Black Sherlock Holmes, Megar Evans. He was the leader of the NAACP, and basically this dude would help black people out anytime something sus would be happening. So Brown versus Board of Education, Emmett Till, he just always made sure black people were getting justified in court. That's my guy right here.
Space. The final frontier.
These are the voyages.
All right, so today I'm going to be talking about Malcolm X. Well, yeah. Malcolm X was one of the most influential but controversial civil rights activists there were out there, you know. You got some good people on the left, you know, like Martin Luther King Jr. Then you got Malcolm X. He was cool. Basically, Malcolm helped grow the African American religious and political movement from just a few people to 75,000. And then he was kicked out for being a little too crazy. But in 1965, he was assassinated, and want to learn more, watch the movie Malcolm. It's pretty good. And yeah, thank you. All right, everyone, that was our, you know, little history lesson on
little culture for today.
Yeah, culture blast, whatever you want to call it.
All right, we'll see you tomorrow, hopefully. R.I.P. Pop Smoke. Very informative series. I think we're going to have a good Black History Week.
It's going to be fun.
All right, there are no birthdays today, sadly, but, you know, that's all right. All right, we're done with announcements. All we got for you today, we're going to see you tomorrow. You know the drill. Catch you on the flip side.
Yeah.